Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 4th of June. India election throws up surprise as PM Modi's alliance scrapes past majority. Kazakhstan removes Taliban from list of terrorist organizations. And Sri Lanka monsoon floods kill over dozen, thousands affected. And now for all the details. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's BJP-led alliance raced to a majority as votes of India's gigantic general elections were counted on Tuesday. However, unlike the last two terms, the numbers fell short of landslide victory as predicted in the post-poll surveys, giving him a slim majority for the third term. A report.
Celebrations erupted across India amongst workers and supporters of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Bharatiya Janata Party as the Saffron Party-led National Democratic Alliance secured a majority in the parliamentary election held over the last few months. As per the vote counting trends till Tuesday evening, the ruling alliance was way past the majority mark of 272 in the 543-member parliament. However, the numbers were well short than what was predicted in the post-poll surveys, which had claimed a landslide victory for the ruling coalition. Unlike the last two terms where PM Modi's BJP won a majority on its own, the Saffron Party also fell short of the majority. While the party had a clean sweep in northern states of Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh, it suffered losses in its bastions of Rajasthan, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh, including a parliamentary constituency of Faizabad, which holds the town of Ayodhya, where a giant Hindu temple was inaugurated by the Prime Minister, completing his party's decade-old poll promise.
Dekhiye, jiska intezar desh ko tha, wo ghadi aa gayi. मोदी जी फिर से प्रधानमंत्री बन रहे हैं देश कह रहा था अब की बार मोदी सरकार फिर एक बार मोदी सरकार आएंगे मोदी जीतेंगे मोदी प्रधानमंत्री बनेंगे मोदी यही देश की आवाज थी अब आ गए मोदी जीत गए मोदी प्रधानमंत्री बन रहे मोदी लगातार तीसरी बार प्रधानमंत्री बनना ये कोई छोटी बात नहीं है
While the ruling coalition had a dull performance than expected, the opposition India Alliance threw a surprise and made substantial gains. The main opposition Congress Party led in more than 90 seats, almost double the 52 it won in the last general election in 2019. Congress scion Rahul Gandhi, who had contested elections from the family bastion of Rae Bareli and southern town of Wayanad, also managed to hold on to the seats for the opposition party. Similarly, making a dent in BJP's bastion Uttar Pradesh, a key member of the opposition bloc, Samajwadi Party led on almost 36 seats, a significant improvement from 5 seats it secured in the 2019 election.
Vinamrata se janmat ko swikar karte hain. Is baar janta ne kisi ek dal ko purn bahumat nahi diya. खासकर सत्ताधारी दल भाजपा ने एक व्यक्ति एक चेहरे के नाम पर वोट मांगा अब यह स्पष्ट हो गया है कि यह मैंडेट मोदी जी के खिलाफ गया है
व्हाइल द नंबर्स हैव बीन पुल्ड डाउन फॉर बीजेपी द पोल रिजल्ट हैज कंफर्मड अ हिस्टोरिक थर्ड टर्म फॉर प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी दो बाय अ स्लिम मार्जिन His party will depend on the allies, which could likely introduce some uncertainty in policy making as compared to the authoritative hold BJP had in the last decade.
Two terrorists, including a self-styled commander of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba outfit, were neutralized by security forces in an encounter in Pulwama district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Monday. Security forces launched a cordon and search operation in the Nihama area of South Kashmir district after receiving specific inputs. Kashmir Zone Police, in a post on X, said that bodies of the two terrorists had been recovered and the security forces were on the job. This year, at least 12 terrorists have been neutralized in anti-terror operations in the Kashmir Valley. And in a major relief to Pakistan's jailed former Prime Minister Imran Khan and ex-Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi, the Islamabad High Court on Monday overturned their jail sentences in a case related to leaking state secrets. 71-year-old Khan was handed a 10-year prison sentence by a special court, which was established under the Official Secrets Act. However, Khan is not going to be released from jail as he is convicted in nearly 200 cases as well since his ouster in April 2022. Imran Khan has been at odds with the country's powerful military, accusing it of him targeting and his party.
It was such an embarrassing case for Pakistan, and I'm really glad that the judiciary sort of came to a conclusion and they buried the charges and declared the ex-prime minister and the ex-foreign minister innocent. As I said again, it should not have dragged that long.
Moving on, scores of Baloch activists and family members of those forcibly disappeared staged protest in parts of Balochistan on Monday. They blamed that Pakistan carries out such atrocities to instill fear and exert its control over the occupied region. A report.
Family members of forcibly disappeared Baloch students Shehak and Farooq Dad staged a protest outside the Commissioner House in Quetta on Monday to know their whereabouts. The Baloch Yakjeti Committee in a post on X said, "The Baloch people are enduring severe human rights violations and struggles to protect their children and loved ones from being extrajudicially abducted and killed. We urge people from all walks of life to join the struggle to reunite the disappeared ones with their families." Meanwhile, a sit-in protest is also underway outside the DC office Kutch, where family members of the victims of forcibly disappeared raised voice against rights violations. Activists say Baloch people have been targets of so-called military operations, ethnic stereotyping and abductions by the Pakistani state, while it continues to exploit their natural resources. They allege that Pakistan repeatedly carries out such atrocities to instill fear and exert control over the Baloch people, who have been demanding independence from its occupation.
Meanwhile, Kazakhstan has officially removed the Taliban from its list of terrorist organizations, according to a statement from the president's press office. President Kasym-Jomart Tokayev, in a meeting of Russia-led Collective Security Treaty Organization, said the move is based on the importance of developing trade and economic cooperation with Afghanistan and the understanding that the Taliban regime is a long-term factor. He emphasized the strategic priority of integrating Afghanistan into regional relations. No country has recognized the Taliban's regime so far over human rights issues. The development also comes amid Russia's efforts to delist the Taliban as a terrorist organization. President Vladimir Putin last week said, "As for today, the Taliban is in power in Afghanistan. We need to proceed with the realities and build relations accordingly." Bangladesh Foreign Minister Hassan Mahmood on Monday slammed German media outlet Deutsche Welle documentary on Bangladesh personnel in United Nations peacekeeping force and said it was made intentionally to undermine the contributions of Bangladeshi troopers. "There is nothing substantial. It is very difficult to understand the essence because it was not made based on facts," Mahmood was quoted as saying by news agency UNB. He added, "While there's a global appreciation for sacrifices of Bangladeshi peacekeepers over the years, the DW document has come up with such anti-state efforts." The German media outlet documentary, titled "Tortures Deployed as UN Peacekeepers," alleges the Bangladeshi personnel, including the controversial Rapid Action Battalion, indulged in human rights abuse, were deployed in UN peacekeeping force. Bangladesh Army has rejected the allegations and have called the reports as misleading and biased. And Sri Lanka has closed schools in the country as the death toll due to floods and mudslides triggered by heavy rains in the island nation has crossed 15. 20 of the island nation's 25 districts were hit by floods, while 5 have been placed on major flood alert as water levels in number of rivers reach alarming levels, according to Sri Lanka's Disaster Management Agency. Media reports citing the Disaster Relief Agency said more than 40,000 people were affected nationwide in the heavy downpour, which have uprooted trees, downed power lines and cut electricity for tens of thousands of people. While the highest amount of rainfall was recorded at 480 mm in central Sri Lanka, Weather Agency has warned monsoon rains are expected to continue in the coming days. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.